Are you the authorities?
Okay, well, my boyfriend and I really need to get off this lake. It's so frustrating.
A book was stolen. It must con-
We got here yesterday afternoon. Just hurry up and find the criminal, okay?
I'll give you the room we were planning to give the... Don't worry, though. Some sort of important book. Real value. Most of them. Since we've got... At any rate...
Who? Oh, sure. Well, I was on my way to the... And the authorities. Delayed by a boating mishap. At this rate, the thief is going to slip away in the night.
Hi, I'm Amir. I don't know if this...
Strides detect. Oh, as soon as why don't you take these keys?
Ah, good. You've good. Who would?
You don't look like any detective I've ever seen. I won't be answering your questions.
Hi. I'm not really sure what-
Oh my gods.
Oh, right. There was an emergency, but don't worry, everything's okay now. Of course, those halls belong to my ancestors and my aunt. Okay. It's just on the ground.
Aha, good news. The real detective has arrived.
Are you the impromptu detective? It seems like you've been doing good. Really? That's very interesting. Let me have a look around. Looks like you're well on your way to becoming a full-fledged... Sad story. Well, and I believe my work here is just about done.
So, now, the ruins will be opened to the university. We'll just have to see what happens.
Well, if on it, you also your best wishes, and, sorry for accusing you of taking my translation book. I'm sure you understand.
Thank the great shade you survived. So, Annie, can't believe you survived. That old Pops, he's got it out for us all!
Strangest thing. After talking to you before, just alone in the woods? Are they okay? Take me to them right away. They must be starving. Good thing you found those kids. Just living off apples for who knows? Not a problem. These two can stay until we talk with the sheriff and find their parents. We're going to need to whip up a meal. Thanks for looking into the apple situation. I never would have expected this. I don't have much, but please, see you.
Shova and Silly are looking after us until I don't know. We were fishing in the ocean with my dad. We woke up on a beach, but Dad wasn't with me. He's shy. He doesn't talk. Thanks for bringing us here.
Hello! Excuse me! I've been stranded in this cove for... My children and I were visiting
Oh, thank the moon and stars!
I have a plan, but I can't do it alone. Oh, thank you! Oh, I'm so lucky you found me. Oh, you've rescued me! I'm eternally grateful. I have to find my children. Do you know where they are? This is a miracle! Thank you! I don't know what I would do without you. I'm going to go and look for them right away. No time to waste.
Thank you. What? A box? Why are you bothering me with something like that? I do, actually. Okay, fine. Let's see it. Well, I can't say I ever expected to see this. Medva was my great-great-grandfather. His mother brought him to Eastshade with nothing to her name except some seeds from their homeland. According to the story, she kept them there, in that very box. She wanted to plant them here so Eastshade would share a piece of home. I can't believe you actually recovered it. Makes sense it would be Lady Samira's scheme, but I can't figure out what she'd want to do with seeds. Doesn't really seem to fit her style. Well, that's about the best thing I've ever heard. Pretty impressive you managed not to fall for her tricks. The seeds must still be in here. I've got another key somewhere. Unless Samira got to that one too somehow. I think I'll try planting them. In pots, of course. They're an invasive species. Thanks for rescuing this for me. It's nice to have a piece of my family's history.
You know what? This box is basically a historical artifact. It would be nice for other travelers to see a part of immigrant history. Would you mind delivering it to the innkeeper up the hill?
My great-great-grandparents built this lodge. What an ornate box. Oh, this is the famous seed box of the Medvay family. I guess it's fitting to display it here, this being the place the Medvay settled. Not at all. But us innkeepers, folks tell us things. Just the other night, I heard the wildest story about a strange musical group out in the woods. You ever think of all the interesting stories we hear night after night? I'm gonna set up a nice plaque for this. A traveling box. How fitting for an inn.
Thank you. Hi again. It's nice to see a familiar... What? Really? A tree door? Let's go see it. You're sure it was here? Well, they seem to have left no trace. And the door and the tree? I believe you. I've been hearing those drums for too long. Something mysterious is afoot. Whatever they're doing, it's clear they don't wish to be discovered. I think you should ask around in Narva. Maybe there's someone who knows more about these Blushwood night drummers. All this investigating has made me thirsty. I think it's quite time for a Lyndowian brew. Let me know if you find out more. Come on by any time.
There. You know, it's so strange. Somebody came in just this morning and donated a book. She said to point people to it if anyone asked about night drumming, which made very little sense to me, considering this book appears to be unrelated to that. Not that I'm entirely sure what night drumming is. It was a little peculiar. Just about every sentence she said was a rhyme. Not sure if she meant to do that or if she was just doing it by accident. An interesting woman. I quite liked her. And then here you are asking about that very topic. So, are you a night drummer? Am I saying that right? Is this a new thing people are doing? Oh, I'm always so behind the times. Sounds curious indeed. Anyway, the book is called The First Folk and it's on shelf C.
Brew you up.
Thank you. Are you from the university? Are you here to relieve us? Oh, sorry. It's a long way north for the typical tourist. We're a research team for the University of Nava, excavating these glaciers in search of an ancient cavern. Records show this place might have been extremely important for early inhabitants. But the progress has been slow. We are kind of expecting the university to send someone calling the whole mission off. In all honesty, it would be a huge relief at this point. We've been struggling. But I digress. I'm Commander Liliana. Nice to meet you. It's great to see a new face. I'd say it's a massive undertaking. Just a team of three, and the project only seems to get bigger each day. Oh, these glaciers. So full of mystery. Look, I'm not a superstitious person. I didn't get to where I am now by believing in spirits and ghosts and the like. But the further we dig, well, things are getting eerie. Visions and sounds we can't explain. This is the reason I wrote to call off the mission. Surely there's a sensible explanation, but my crew has other notions. It's driving a wedge between us, undoubtedly. It's kind of ridiculous. Obviously, there's no such thing as being haunted. And now, just as we reach the cavern entrance, the tunnel collapsed again, blocking us out. No way to tell how bad the damage is. To top it off, I made the stupid call to leave the artifact bins in there last night. I might have lost everything. Months of progress, lost in a single night. We're at our wits' end, that's for sure. We can arrange that, but let's plan for tomorrow. It's been a long day already, and the crew will be wrapping up soon. We have a supply tent I'm sure you could squeeze into. Does it have the extra padding and lining to survive a night out here? I'd rather you use ours than turn into an icicle. I'll sort the tent out for you. In the meantime, why don't you get to know the crew a little better? They'd appreciate seeing a new face.
Had a chat with Commander Liliana, did you? She managed to recruit you yet? Maybe you can take my spot and I'll head back to Nava. Right. There are records of an ancient spirituality in the area. It seems to me that we might have struck a curse by opening this tunnel. No. A curse set in place by ancient and sacred rituals. We can't be sure how these things work, but it seems they do, based on the terrible experiences we've had. Well, we've seen these figures surrounding our camp. They're always whispering. Mira, she's got it the worst. She hears something talking to her all the time. Almost like a demon, by the way she describes it. The texts on this area of the world are sparse. There is some information that hints heavily at curses, but I haven't found much on how to reverse them. Well, we've seen these figures surrounding our camp. They're always whispering. Mira, she's got it the worst. She hears something talking to her all the time. Almost like a demon, by the way she describes it. I'll tell you, we're all very much looking forward to getting away from here. As exciting as the cavern find may be, I just don't get a good feeling from it. Mira's been having an especially hard time with everything. She specializes in glaciology. Well, Liliana is worried that Mira should have been able to foresee the cave-in. They had a falling out this morning. Not that I should be telling you any of this, but I'm worried about her. I think it'd be great for her to see a new face. We're all starting to get under each other's skin. She walked up to the northern shore. It's a nice place to take a break. Seems less cursed, I guess.
Hello? Are you real? Oh dear. Well, that shows you what state I'm in. I didn't expect to see a tourist all the way out here. Yeah, this is one creepy place. Best day of my life when I set foot on this big old block of ice. But now, I really wish we'd never come at all. Who told you that? Was it Fadir? He's always butting into things. My grandmother told me about spirits that haunt people who make bad choices. I always thought she was just getting me to behave. But what if it's real? What, in my whole life? A lot of things. But since we've been here, nothing. I stole Liliana's dessert rations. Tell me, what would you suggest I do about the thing that won't stop talking to me? Okay, I know you're just trying to be helpful, but I actually don't feel like talking about it anymore. It's a lot to deal with. What did you want to ask about? We're trying to access an important cavern inside the ice, but someone, or something, doesn't want us to find it. Strange things have been happening ever since we got here. This place is just creepy. What did you want to ask about? Fadir's a historian and an archaeologist. He was one of my professors at university. He thinks there's a curse bringing on the demons. He has all kinds of ideas to break the curse. But I think they're just making things worse. Liliana is our commander. She says she doesn't hear any of the voices or see any of the creepy things we do. But I think she's lying. She's just trying to protect us. Bye.
I think I managed to make enough space for you in the tent. Might be a little cozy, though. It's yours to use when you're ready.
I heard voices. Tens of voices, all whispering so loudly my brain felt like it would burst.
We can't go in there.
I came out here to check up. I tried to stop her. We don't have a choice now.
Oh my gods, how is this happening?
She yelled something about finding out what they want and just ran right in. It's not safe in there. I don't know why we're still standing here. I'm going in after her.
Okay, Fedir has lost his mind too. You should go first.
Nope, we're going in. Let's move. That's an order!
Hey, are you all right? It seems we've all had a bout of hallucinations. I think you might have managed to save us somehow. When I came to, I found you here, next to all our artifact bins. I thought maybe you were trying to build some kind of shield, but you must have stacked them up, and that hole, of course it's a vent! When you pulled out those ice chunks, all the spores dissipated! Look at all this icy fungus. Fedir just identified it as a highly potent hallucinogen. We must have been breathing in the spores while we were digging. And that led to some powerful experiences. Mine was about 4 golden owls, leading me down a path to... Well, it doesn't matter. Better than they've been in a long, long time. You don't know how relieved I am that it wasn't a curse or a wild flock of demons. Mira and Fedir nearly had me convinced. To think, we've been making our situation worse with every step forward. I'm not sure how you knew what to do, but I'm glad you were able to air out the spores. Thanks to you, we survived and even managed to recover the artifacts.
Welcome back. We've got plenty more patrons interested in your work. Not bad.
Password. Come on in then.
Thank you. Welcome, friend. We haven't seen you here before. The Shez insist that the dream teas should be sacrificed to Tiem, their goddess. They grow the teas, care for them, then leave the plants to waste. That's fine for them, but now they want to confiscate all of our tea, too. What? What do they ask you to do? Oh my. This is a step further than they've ever gone. Ugh! I hate that we have to deal with this nonsense. These nonsense people and their nonsense cause. Could I have this vial? I don't know exactly what it does, but I can only imagine it's a virus that will kill our tea vine. Thank you. I will have this safely disposed of. Thank you for bringing this information to me. We will have to take extra precautions to protect ourselves and our vines from these zealots. Sheesh, these people have really outdone themselves. Here, as a token of my thanks, please take this book. It went out of print years ago. I think I've just about memorized everything in it. From one explorer to another, I think some of these brews will pique your interest. Farewell.
You got my message, and you came. Oh, it's so good to finally meet a Skyfolk. I mean, other than Mudwillow. But I guess she's not really a Skyfolk, since she does live underground. Maybe you've met her. Anyway, please forgive all the sneaky. I should introduce myself. I am a Leho. My people call ourselves Macha, but I believe your people might better know us as the First Folk. Sadly, my people wouldn't exactly approve of me meeting with a Skyfolk. Please, don't take that in a bad way. As a people, most of us are just very... No, more like... I guess you could say we do not like to mingle with outsiders. But not me. For as long as I can remember, I have been fascinated by the Skyfolk. The stories, the architecture, the language. I have dedicated quite a lot of time to learning your tongue, after all. I am grateful to Mudwillow for being such a willing teacher. And the variety. Is it true that there are bear folk? Do they have temper like a bear? Ah, of course, like my own people. They are people, after all, each different. Ah, I have so many questions for you. I hope it's not too bad to ask, but is it true that your people are removing the eyes of the firstborn? Aha! I knew it! I wonder what other lies my people are making up about the Skyfolk. And what is your trade? Wow, that's very good. My sister is an artist too. She's an etcher, carves designs into the walls and such things. Well, I should probably leave here. Someone will notice I'm gone if I'm out for much longer. Ooh, tell me, do you think you could make me a painting of the big city? Mudwillow told me about it, but I want to see it. That would be incredible. I don't have much to give you, though. We could meet here again, same time tomorrow night. That would be incredible. Paint it from afar, yes? I want to see the skyline. To be honest, I like to be beneath the sky and stars. I think we all do. That's why every so often, some of us come up here to make music. Ah, to feel the rhythm of music under the stars. Most feel it's worth the risk of being heard. I think I'm going to make a habit of coming up here every night. I hope to see you soon. It was a pleasure speaking with you. Hello again, my sky friend. I hope you're well. I myself was just having a nice think under the stars. I was dreaming about what it would be like to live up here. It must be nice to always have the sky above. I do like home. The halls are warm, and everyone I love is there. But the sky speaks to me. Have you had the chance to make a painting of the big city? Ah, it is beautiful. Your people's buildings are incredible. I am sorry, I don't have any of your kind of money. My people use something we call egra. I don't know how it's called in your tongue. I am still learning your language from Mudwillow. It is rock where animal has died. It is leaving like a print in the rock. Fossil. Yes, the fossil of a snail we use. What do your people use? Glowstones? We have lots of this. The rock of our home is rich with them. I can give you. You know, I would really like if you came to meet my people. You are a nice person. I think meeting you would help them see that outsiders are nothing to be scared of. Will you come with me to meet my people? I can show you my home and get you some glowstones. Forgive me, but I'm going to have to ask to blindfold you. As much as I consider you a friend, my kin would not appreciate disclosing the way to our home. I will guide you. It's not far. Is that acceptable? Watch your step. This way. Not much further now. We have arrived. Please, wait here just one moment. I went ahead and told most of the others that you're coming, so they won't get too startled. I've let them know you're completely friendly, but some of my people may still be alarmed. Please, pay no mind to any strange looks. This way, if you please. Well, this is our home. What do you think? Oh, that will make us all feel very proud when I tell the others. I am glad you like it. We have been expanding for many generations now. We believe, as your own scholars do, that we Machra were indeed the first folk to settle here. Our legend has it that the great sea captain Ilanit and her crew landed here after being lost at sea for 1,000 days without food or water. It's probably a bit exaggerated. But I do think Ilanit was a real person and truly fearless. She braved the ocean after all. I can think of nothing more terrifying than this. No, really? The sky speaks to me, but the ocean? No. Wow. Well, I'm glad you made it, so that we could find each other and become friends. Well, here are some glowstones. I hope that's sufficient. I truly am glad to have met you. You have taught me so much. I was thinking, one day I may want to go from here, go into the world, just to see. Do you think the Skyfolk would welcome me? Oh, that would be incredible. But I'm not ready yet. One day. I think your visit here will go a long way with my people. Now that they've seen you, a perfectly friendly one, it will plant the seed of acceptance. I dream that one day the Nahra can be friendly with the Skyfolk. I feel both our cultures would be richer. Okay, I'll let you look around a bit. Then I'll take you back. Are you ready? Farewell, my friend.
Got some junk to sell. Did I mention some people call? I only ever have one item for sale at 500. Sealant. Would you like to buy some sealant? Holy moly, gotta say, I didn't expect you would have the dough. Usually the people who buy my stuff are either rich folk or business is in a pinch.
Can I brew you up?
A tale of trickery and wit. There was once a witch who lived in a tiny hut at the edge of a swamp. She was skilled in the healing arts and could cure nearly any ailment. Though she had many visitors, her truest companions were a cluster of spiders living under her table. One day, a man ambled up the path and knocked upon her door.
You must be the wise witch, Fletcher of all ears.
He looked around and thought of a smile.
Keep across the world for your cures and let you live in this terrible shack. Surely folks pay dearly for the chance to continue grieving.
But Flora was not one for glowstones, and she quite liked her home. She only stiffened and asked what his ailment was. So, he told her of the terrible pains and aches he suffered. Horrible scratching in his toenails, in each strand of hair, and in his tear ducts. Ah, it was a torture like none other. But he'd heard of the cure, only to be found in the swamp near her home. The only way to ease his pain? The heart root. Well, in all her years of saving lives, Flora had never heard of such a root. But the Borg wasn't so treacherous, and she had gone in many times for lesser cures. So, she agreed to find the heart root, and the man agreed to wait in her hut. Flora trudged through the swamp, thick with slime, and the stinking air heavy with rot. When she came to a clearing of black clay, she thrust her hands into the wet muck, but alas, nothing. She dug for hours, her back aching and fingernails packed with mud. Finally, just as twilight fell, she found a spiral green tube.
My great...
Do you have any weeds for me, traveler? Farewell, traveler.
Greetings. I have a message for you from North Seas Shipping. Safe travels.
back to the mainland? Do you already have a ticket or are you looking to buy? Oh, you were on the Annabelle. Terribly sorry about that. Do you wish to board now? You don't have to take this ship. There are many coming through, all going to the mainland. Your ticket is valid for any North Sea shipping vessel. Once you board, there's no turning back. You'll be mainland bound. Are you done with all your business here in Eastshade? We've got you in the very best room. Go right ahead. Have a nice trip.